Hey guys, this is Tom from Horizon Hobby and Spektrum RC. We're going to do a tutorial on how to add Crossfire to your DX9. Now, this is a modification, so if you're modifying your radio, you need to be aware that you're going to be voiding your warranty. So keep that in mind. We do have a service through our service center to be able to do this modification for you if you don't want to void your warranty. So let's get to the bench. Things that we're going to need are, of course, a screwdriver to open up the radio, our TBS Crossfire. Once you purchase a TBS Crossfire, it's going to come with a couple of cables. We're going to have one for power. It's this guy here with the yellow connector. That's an XT30. You're also going to have some cables for plugging it into the different inputs. You can reuse those, or what we're going to do here is use our IX12 TBS Crossfire adapter. You can purchase that on horizonhobby.com or your local retailer. And we're going to combine that with a everyday servo lead like this guy and a little extension. And you'll see here what I've done is I've essentially taken just this connector. It's the 6-pin connector. It's got two wires, the blue and black, and soldered it to a female portion of a servo lead. All right, so we've got our DX9 here. This is a DX9 black. You can also do this modification with the DX9 silver, so essentially any DX9. And we've already got the screws loosened up, but you'll see that there are 8 holes for the screws. They take a number 1 Phillips head screwdriver to get them off, so I've already removed all those. There is a little trick to getting the antenna off. You push it forward, and it'll come off like that. Be careful not to kink this antenna, so we'll just kind of be conscious of that. And we'll take the back off. Usually it takes a little bit of wiggle, just like that. Now, be careful when you force pull this off, because there are going to be some wires tethered to the back of it. Like if you see here, this is one of the antennas. We want to make sure that we take it out of this housing, because it's going to be pulling on it. And it simply just pulls right out of there. It kind of opens up. It's got a little clasp. Okay, we've taken the antenna out of here, and we've laid down the top here. So you'll see that we're going to be accessing these ports right here, and if you see the diagram that we pull up, we're looking at J16. There are 4 holes, and we're using the 2 middle. We've labeled them TX and ground. TX for signal, ground for ground. So I've taken my servo lead and I have stripped it down to expose the signal end and the ground. And we've got the other end here that we're going to fish out through the back of our DX9. And we're going to solder those to the 2 pads that we just shown in that diagram. Okay, so we're going to tin these 2 pads that you saw in the diagram, the top, middle, there, the second one down is TX, the next one's going to be ground. We're going to take a little bit of solder and tin that. All right, now that you see that I've got these tinned, we're going to solder our signal, which on our wire is an orange wire, to the TX pin hole. Once again, it's the second one down. Do your best not to bridge the connection. They are pretty close together. If you want to get creative, you could use like a little plug and solder it in there as well. But we're just going to do it straight to the holes. Like that. And now we're going to solder the ground. It's the 3rd pin down. We're going to take our black wire as the ground to our connector and solder it in there. There we go, and we'll double check our work. It looks like I haven't bridged anything. We're good to go. Once we've got the wire soldered to the TX and ground pinholes, we want to secure the wire somewhere so that it's not rubbing against our gimbals. You know, you don't want to get anywhere in there, shorting anything out. So I'm going to attach my wires here to this little eyelet here. We use this for attaching wires to keep them out of the way of the gimbals. Got a little zip tie, feed it through. So now we're going to figure out where we're going to take our wire out of the back. Some people will use the battery door. I'm going to use this little rubber plug here. You can simply just press through the back. So if we press on the back of the plug, it'll just pop out like that. And to get it through that hole, we're going to release the wires from the servo connector end. You can do that by just lifting up the tabs here, pulling the wires out. And fishing them through here. So now that our wires are through our hole, we're going to reconnect it to our connector. So now we're going to put our DX9 back together. Set her down and put our antenna back on. Once again, you kind of lean it forward and snap it backwards. And then we can put our two screws back in. All right, so now that we've got the crossfire lead coming out of our DX9, we're going to go ahead and plug in the adapter that I made. And you can see that'll plug straight into our crossfire module. And you can mount this however you like onto the back of the radio. You can use double-sided tape, some locking Velcro, or you can download the STL file and print out your own, whatever you like. All right, now that we've got our DX9 back together, you'll need to update the radio to use the Crossfire protocol. So if you go to Spektrum RC and you have this radio registered, you'll see that there is an update for the Crossfire protocol. Just look down your list of updates and you'll have one that says Crossfire. Download that one, install it into your radio. If you don't know how to do that, there's another video that we'll leave in the description for you to link to. So my radio is up to date with the Crossfire firmware. We're going to go ahead and turn that on. I'll just show you how to enable the Crossfire protocol. Click on the scroll wheel, and we're going to scroll down to System Setup. Tap Yes. And we're looking for Serial Port Setup. What we just soldered in was the serial port. We'll use this for this. Tap on that. Protocol. Change that to Crossfire. And then turn Spektrum RF off or inhibit. And now your radio is feeding all of its data through that port that we just soldered up in the back. You can attach your Crossfire and you're ready to go. If you guys need more help or if you need more information, go to horizonhobby.com.